Hello friends, in last video we have discussed loop analysis. Now we can solve some numerical based on that loop analysis. So we can take first, so this circuit diagram is given and in that we have to find out loop current. So I can mark first loop and loop current. Now here there are three loops. This is first loop, this is second loop and this is third loop. Now mark the loop current. So for first loop, this direction of loop current, that is I1, this current is I2 and this current is I3, and then apply Kirchhoff's voltage law for this three loop. So consider first loop. First loop, it is this loop. Now apply KVL. Current direction is like this, so I can mark this polarity plus minus, this plus minus. So apply KVL, so it is minus 2 I1 plus minus, so it is minus, so it is minus 2 I1. Then this 4 ohm, it is common for first loop and second loop. So we can take it as positive to negative, so there is voltage drop, so we can take it that drop, it is minus 4, minus, so it is minus 4 as we are considering first loop. So first loop current, that is I1 minus I2, and then battery EMF negative to positive, so it is plus 10 is equal to 0. When we solve this equation, we are getting minus 6 I1 plus 4 I2 equals to minus 10, that is your first equation. Now we are apply second, we are consider second loop and apply KVL. I can write here second loop, start from this. So current direction is like this, this plus, this plus minus, here like this, plus minus. So it is, second equation is minus 6 I1, sorry, minus 6 I2, then this 10, it is common for second and third loop. So plus minus, so I take this drop minus 10 as we are considering second loop. So second loop current minus third loop current. So it is I2 minus I3. And then here 4 ohm resistance. Again it is common for first and second. But here as we consider second loop, so or we are write down that equation for second loop. So second loop current minus first loop current, and current direction is like this, so it is plus minus, so we can take it this drop minus 4, so it is minus 4 I2 minus I1 is equal to 0. So when we solve this equation, we are getting 4 I1 minus 20 I2 plus 10 I3 is equal to 0, that is your second equation. Now apply KVL for third loop. So again this is the direction, so I can mark this polarity plus minus, this is plus and minus. So start from this, current is I3, so it is minus 5 I3, battery source plus minus, so we can take it as minus, so minus 20, and here this plus minus, so this drop is minus 10. But again, this resistance is common for second and third loop. But we are writing this equation for third loop. So, it is I3 minus I2. So, minus 10 I3 minus I2 is equal to 0. So, when we solve this equation, we are getting 10 I2 minus 15 I3 is equal to 20. That is your third equation. So we are getting this three equation, these are simultaneous equation. So when we solve this three equation, we are getting the values of loop current I1, I2 and I3. After solving this, we are getting I1, it is 1.25 ampere, I2 it is minus 0.625 ampere and I3 it is minus 1.75 ampere. This negative sign indicates the answer is not wrong, just your assumed direction is wrong. So we are getting this three loop current by using loop analysis. If it is asked, we can find out the current flowing only through the 6 ohm resistance. So 6 ohm resistance, that current I2 is flowing. In that case, it is not necessary to find out all the current. You can find out only this I2. So this is about application of loop analysis for this circuit. Okay, we can take second example. So this circuit is given and we have to find out the loop current. So here there are three loops. This is first loop, this is second loop, and this is third loop. So I can mark this loop current. So this loop current is I1, this loop current is I2, and this loop current is I3. So apply KVL for this first loop. First loop, it is starting from this and end with this. So apply KVL for first loop, we are getting, I can mark the polarity, current direction is like this, this plus, this minus, plus minus, plus minus, and plus minus. So I1 is current, so it is minus 3 I1. Then 5 ohm, it is common for first and second loop. As we are considering first loop, so current is I1 minus I2, and plus minus, that drop is minus. So minus 5 I1 minus I2. Then this 5, it is common for first and third loop, and this is again plus minus, so it is minus 5 I1 minus I3. Then this minus 5 I1 plus 10 volt minus 2 I1 is equal to 0. So when we solve this equation, we are getting minus 20 I1 plus 5 I2 plus 5 I3 is equal to minus 10. That is your first equation. Now apply the equation for second loop. Start from here, current direction is like this, so this plus minus, plus minus, plus minus, this plus and minus. So I2 is current flowing. So second equation, it is minus 7 I2 minus 3 I2 plus minus, so minus 5 volt. This 5 ohm, it is common second and third loop. So as we consider second loop, so it is I2 minus I3, and plus minus, so it is voltage drop, it is minus sign. So it is minus 5 I2 minus I3. Again, this is common for first and second loop, plus minus, so it is minus 5. As we are writing this equation for second loop, so second loop current minus first loop, so I2 minus I1 is equal to 0. So after solving this, we are getting 5 I1 minus 20 I2 plus 5 I3 equals to 5. This is your second equation. Now apply KVL for this third loop. So this is the current direction. I can mark the polarity, plus minus, plus minus, and in this direction, so plus minus. Start from this, plus minus, so drop is minus, and current is I3. But 5 ohm, it is common second and third loop. So as we are considering third loop, so I3 minus I2. So it is minus 5 I3 minus I2. Then it is minus 5 I3 minus 5 volt, and minus 5, it is common for first and third, but as we consider third loop, so minus 5 I3 minus I1 is equal to 0. So when we solve this equation, we are getting 5 I1 plus 5 I2 minus 15 I3 is equal to 5. That is your third equation. So we are getting this three simultaneous equation. So when we solve this three equation, you know how to solve that simultaneous equation. So after solving that three equation, we are getting I1 equals to 0.371 ampere, I2 equals to minus 0.228 ampere, and I3 equals to minus 0.285 ampere. So we are getting this current. Negative means you assume direction is wrong. Basically it is in this direction. So this is the answer for this. We are getting this three loop currents I1, I2 and I3. Thank you.